In this video, we will talk about how to find a loop and how to use loop pivoting to find a better basic feasible solution from the initial basic feasible solution. Loop pivoting is an important step in the transportation simplex method. Understanding loop pivoting will help you understand how to solve the transportation problem. First of all, what is a loop? A loop is an ordered sequence of at least 4 different cells that satisfy all these 3 conditions. The first condition is that any 2 consecutive cells should lie in either the same row or the same column. The second condition is that no 3 or more consecutive cells should lie in the same row or column. The third condition is that the last cell must be in the same row or column as the first cell. You can consider a loop as a closed path. Now let's see some examples. In this example, we have a total of 16 cells. We only pick these 4 cells and connect them. If we go in this direction, we can find a path represented by the coordinates of these 4 cells. For example, the first cell is in row 2 and column 1, so it's represented by 2, 1. The second cell is in row 2 and column 3, so it is represented by 2, 3, and so on. Note that we do not consider the cell in the middle here. We jump over this cell and connect the first cell and the second cell. Is this a loop? We need to check the definition. It does contain at least 4 cells, and in this case exactly 4. Now let's check the first condition. If you pick any 2 consecutive cells, they lie in either the same row or same column. For example, this cell and this cell, they are in the same row. This cell and this cell, they are in the same column. What about this cell and this cell? They are not in the same row or the same column, but they are not consecutive cells. So the first condition is satisfied. The second condition, no 3 or more consecutive cells in the same row or column. We cannot find a counterexample, so this condition is also satisfied. The last condition, the last cell should be in the same row or column as the first cell. This is the last cell, and this is the first cell. They are in the same column. So this condition is satisfied. Therefore, this is indeed a loop. Let's check the second example. We pick 8 cells out of 16 cells. We can build a path like this. Let's check if this is a loop. Condition 1 is satisfied because any 2 consecutive cells are in the same row or column. Condition 2 is satisfied because we do not have 3 or more consecutive cells in the same row or column. Condition 3 is also satisfied because the last cell is in the same column as the first cell. So this is also a loop. Let's check the third example. We pick 4 cells out of 8 cells. We can build a path like this. Let's check if this is a loop. Condition 1 is not satisfied because these 2 consecutive cells are not in the same row or column. Same thing for these 2 cells. Therefore, it's not a loop. We don't even have to check conditions 2 and 3. Last example, we pick 5 cells out of 6 cells. We build a path like this. Is this a loop? Condition 2 is not satisfied because we have 3 consecutive cells in the same row, so it's not a loop. After we understand what a loop is, then take a look at the loop pivoting technique, which is used to go from one basic feasible solution to a better basic feasible solution. Step 1, determine the entering variable. Step 2, find a loop that starts from the entering variable and covers some of the basic variables. It turns out there is only one such loop. Note that we do not require to cover all the basic variables. Step 3, count the cells in the loop, label them as odd cells or even cells. The entering variable will be marked as 0. Step 4, find the smallest value among all the odd cells. If we have 2 or more smallest cells, randomly select one of them. Code this value theta. The variable in the cell will be the living variable. Decrease each odd cell in the loop by theta and increase each even cell in the loop by theta. After these 5 steps, you will have an improved basic feasible solution. Now I'll use this example to illustrate how loop pivoting works. Consider this transportation tableau. We obtain a basic feasible solution using the northwest corner method. Since we don't really need the cost and the supply-demand information in the loop pivoting process, I just remove them so we can focus on the 5 pivoting steps. Step 1, we need to determine the entering variable. We will talk about how to determine which variable should be the entering variable later. But for now, let's just assume we already know this cell will be the entering variable. Step 2, find the loop and the only loop that starts from the entering variable and covers some basic variables. If we start here, we can go in 2 directions, either down or left. We'll randomly pick to go down. We do not want to stop in the middle because we try to cover some basic variables. We stop at 30, which represents a basic variable. Now we can only go to the left from here and stop at 10. Then we go up and stop at 20. Then we go left, but should we stop at 20 or should we stop at 10? Let's try to stop at 20. Then we need to go from 20 to 10 in the next step. But in this case, we have 3 consecutive cells in the same row, which violates the loop definition. So we must jump over 20 in the previous step and stop at 10 directly. After that, we go up and go right to form a loop. We can also start from the entering variable and go left first. We will end up with the same loop, it's just that the direction is reversed. In step 3, we need to count the cells in the loop and label them as odd cells and even cells. We start from the entering variable 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0. The odd cells are marked in green and the even cells are marked in red. In step 4, we find the smallest value among all the odd cells. The smallest value is 20. Give this value to theta. This cell will be the living variable. In step 5, decrease each odd cell in the loop by theta and increase each even cell in the loop by theta. The living variable will be changed to 0, and the entering variable will be changed to positive 20. This is the new basic feasible solution. Okay, in this video we talked about how to do the loop pivoting to find a better basic feasible solution from the initial basic feasible solution. Thank you for watching.